Mingma Norbu Sherpa has been with Himalayan Trust Nepal for many years and has been a wise and reliable partner for Himalayan Trust New Zealand. And he's represented the wishes of the Trust, its members and donors so well. In my new capacity as General Manager, it's been an absolute privilege to work with Mingma and talk with him on, up until now, it's been entirely on Zoom. But his knowledge of the issues that the people of Solo Kumbu face is invaluable. So normally I would talk about what's going on with the Himalayan Trust at the moment in Nepal, but I'm delighted to welcome Mingma Norbu here to present a summary of the healthcare work, the education work that the Himalayan Trust is doing in Nepal. So thank you, Mingma.
So, Napa, we we talk about the education. Now I'm going to talk about only the health program here. So this is the doctor, Mingma Norbu, working at Pune Hospital. And I'm sure, I'm glad that Carol and Ian are here, and Dr. Lin is staying here, and maybe Dr. Michael, and some other doctors might have visited Pune, and everybody know Pune Hospital. And so the number of the patients that in the Congo region is slightly decreasing, and which in a sense is a good result because of the Himalayan Trust project interventions, and the healthcare system has improved, and the economy and livelihood of the local people have been changed a lot. And also there are more health facilities available. And so here the total annual number of patients treated by Pune Hospital is 6,000, hospital as well as three community clinics is 6,000, approximately 6,000. And among that, 4,595 were treated from Pune Hospital. And we have Monju, Thani, and Fortse, three community clinics, which treated 1,468 patients annually. And last year, we were successful to organize an eye clinic, eye campaign at Kunde Hospital in coordination with Dilganga Eye Institute, which is very specialized for eye clinic, and has been perhaps best one in South Asia. And 29 eyes were operated at Kunde Hospital for cataract. And here Dr. Kami, checking and taking care of the Rinpoche at Rimijung Monastery. And the health camps, occasionally we organize health camps from Kunde Hospital to various villages and communities. And that also helps for the elderly people and some people who can't walk to the hospital. And this is Dr. Mingma Kanji working at Kunde Hospital, and also the community clinic visits at Kortse. And she, both Dr. Kani and Dr. Mingma Kanji, I think after Carol, Dr. Kani has taken over the management of Kunde Hospital, and Dr. Mingma Kanji became the second doctor. She is the daughter of Mingma Jemba. And so the medicines, we also supply medicines for Park Hospital and the clinics and the Kunde Hospital and many Shotang Hospital and many community clinics, and which the picture itself tells the expense, the position and the messages. And Fablu Hospital is the biggest hospital in the district, Sorghum District, and since it is a government-owned district hospital, it receives a lot of patients, but at the same time it is under resource, and so Himalayan Trust through the our partner from Germany, Sir Edmund Hillary Stutton, Germany, their funds for the staff salary as well as the medicine supplies. So we provide medicines and a doctor insight for the Pablo Hospital, and so from the Pablo Hospital annually 15,000 people get treatment. Likewise, Namchi Dental Clinic, the world's highest dental clinic, this was built by the American Himalayan Foundation in 1990s, so the major donor was Richard Bloom, who happened to be Sir Ed's one of the best friends, and now the management, we are looking after the dental clinic's management. We provide the technical and management support. In terms of the organization management and the staff salary payment and reporting to the government and reporting to the local government and auditing the finance and so forth. So Himalayan Trust Nepal is taking care of that. And here, this is the dentist. And in addition to the management support, sometimes the clinic gets shortages of supplies. And sometimes the equipment, the dental chair breaks, and sometimes many problems, unforeseen problems comes, and in that case, we provide additional support, and I think we were lucky to get some funding from through Dr. Lindsay. I think we got some support to buy some of the, replace some of the broken equipments. And also, in addition to that, we also provided computers to the dentist to prepare the reports. And the dentist didn't have a computer to that. So here, dental camps in the communities at the various schools, monasteries. Apart from the service from the clinic, they also, the doctors and the hygienists go to the go to different clinics and communities and provide the services. And brought support for various clinics, in Patle, Goli, Sopan, Boom, and Pablo. And this is our, we have a new partner, the partnership with the Forgotten Shepherds of Nepal Trust. This logo here stands for Forgotten Shepherds of Nepal Trust, which is a Geraldine-based charity organization. And they are supporting two clinics at Goli, and Goli in Solukhumbu and Patle in Pokhara district. So we are also managing those two clinics in partnership with them. And as Peter has mentioned, and the first classroom, school classroom block at Kunjung School has been now converted as a third-year visitor center. And we wanted to set up this visitor center because you know, the young, the older generations now they gradually pass away, and the younger generation may not know much about, and they haven't met Sir Ed, and they may not know the history. So that's why we felt it is important to set up this visitor center to tell the younger generation about the work of the Himalayan Trust and Sir Ed's support for the Solukhumbu district. So this center has been built in partnership with Peter, Sarah, Rick Person, Alexa, and Nick. The technical supports come from them, and Peter and Sarah has also taken care of the fundraising for the center and also providing the additional technical and management support. And Himalayan Trust Nepal itself has raised over 85,000 New Zealand dollars, and we also invested for this center. And the center, 90% of the construction and establishment work has been done. And so this is a kind of setting that we furnish, that furnishing that we have done, and it will be ready by the 70th anniversary. It will be inaugurated on 29th of May, and we welcome you all here. So Sotang Hostel, we are also building one hostel, a school hostel for Sotang, and some of the kids there walk for five hours or a day to reach the school, and they are poor school students, but they are very bright, and they deserve to have a nice hostel. But so far they do not have any. They have a hostel, but it looks like a worse than an animal heart. So so we felt very sympathized to them and sympathetic to them. So we, with the funding support from the Grand Circle Foundation in USA, we are building the hostel. And I would like to mention that, you know, not only Himalayan Trust New Zealand, but also we are getting more partnership support from other agencies, and we share the credit equally. So you can share the credit equally, and anything that we Himalayan Trust Nepal does, it is a common interest of Himalayan Trust New Zealand and Nepal, and that's how Sir Ed worked before, and we want to keep that legacy alive. Livelihood programs. This is one of the good examples of how multi-partners work together and make a success and to change the livelihoods of the people. And people in the Everest region, just by the right by the national park boundary at Monzu and Chumuan, the two villages, there are 277 households and over 300 people, and more than 60,000 trekkers pass by that trail every year. And we design a joint water and fire hydrant project, and for which Himalayan Trust New Zealand and Land Rover New Zealand supported one of the major components of the project. and then Slovak aid can get 30,000 euro, and likewise the Kumbu Pasanam rural municipality and the Sarma National Park in Robertson from the local government also contributed some funding. So with the multiple donors' support, the project had been successfully completed, and this happened. This project was implemented during the COVID-19 in the first wave, and so when there was no tourism, no trackers coming in, so it also generated some employment for the local people. And now the project is really working good, and people are using for clean drinking water and irrigation to the kitchen garden, and also for fire hydrant, just in case fire breaks out there. So this is the water source is located here. It comes very through the very rocky cliff and crosses to the Kosi River and goes to Manzu, and then from Manzu it is distributed to the Manzu. And then there's another river crossing at Suma, and then it goes all the way down to Suma near Bangkok. So it's a very innovative and new project. And we do have other requests from Jersey and Bangkok for similar project, and where the local government has put some like almost like a 6 million rupees for the Bangkok, and there are some shortages of the fund for these two projects, and we are still looking funding partnership in the future. And this is another livelihood for education project that we have. Got a funding support from Germany, and Lights for Kids. This is a small organization, and he's the chairperson who came to trekking through Pasan's connection, chairperson's connection, and they supported 120 solar systems, solar home system for 120 households. So, and the objective is to provide lights for kids to read and study at home. Because they can entire this village is called Boksur, and Mangerku are located other side of Cheskam, which is considered one of the most remote areas of Solomon District. And so it's a very impressive project there. Other events and management, over the last fiscal year we had every 11th of January we hold a board meeting, and we in the board meeting we first the members serve it. That's I think the 11th January is the subjects the day that subject passed away, right? So on that day we organize the 11th January the board meeting and decide various community petitions. We receive many petitions from the community schools, projects for financial support, and we screen the projects and make a board decision and select the project and provide the fund. And the funding comes from New Zealand Aid and Human Trust New Zealand. And this 2 million, the total amount of the project is 2 million Nepalese rupees, which I guess is about 16,000 New Zealand dollars. And so we, from the Himalayan Trust Nepal, we do a frequent project monitoring and visits to the project sites and meet the stake people, their beneficiaries, and interact them how the project is going and whether it's going on the right direction or wrong, or if they have any feedback. So from the board and staff, from the management, we organize frequent monitoring visits to the project sites. And this is, as I told you, this is a volunteer school that Dr. Lin Sistang, in 72, isn't so late, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a family.
It's very good.
Yeah. Now the school itself is not used as a school because the government took over for a couple of years, and then I think because of the threat with the Glacier Lake Outlaws Club and also the economic opportunities, most of the people they have moved to Kathmandu, and there are only few people left there. But there's a monk, Rinpoche, who's a very visionary and hardworking, and he said that they should run a monastic school. So next to the school, in the village there's a monastery, and in the monastery they set up a monastery school, and which has over 30 students, and our partner from Switzerland, the National Foundation, is paying this salary of one teacher for 10 years. And through the Himalayan Trust funding support, we provide the stationaries, the books and whiteboards and pens and pencils and scales or markers or whatever the schools need. So so the school is running very well. So here are more photographs of the monitoring visits, Namzi School, Dad School, and Jumbishi School, Namzi Clinic, Mountain Water, and the computer lab in Aviation. And this is the Sotan Hostel building. The Stern Foundation Program. And also now we have the federal government, and since the federal government has formed and all the rules and regulations has been changed, and we have to work very closely with the local government, and without the without your approval, non-profit organizations cannot operate any projects in the areas. And this was not the case in old days. In the old governments, like 20 years ago, we could just get us approval, annual approval from the district headquarters. But now, each of the district's authority has been delegated to the local government, local at the rural at the village level. So the local government, in a way, it has become very strong. We can formulate acts and rules and regulations and can implement. So that means they have the very independent, autonomous power. And therefore, any projects that we operate has to be authorized, approved by the local government. So we have to, annually we have to report them, we have to get the consensus from them, and we cannot upset them. And NGO is not a competitor for the government, and we are just supporting their goals and objectives. And where their resources are, where they are lacking their resources, we're just supporting them. And so that's why, so we have to be very diplomatically working with them. And there's also win-win position. If we work closely with them, we also can get funding support, partnership funding support from them. And that makes more projects more sustainable. Therefore, we visited different schools and municipalities to share our programs and annual progress report, and then try to seek more partners, stronger linkages and partnership support. And now, in terms of the management, we got new staff members, and so here, these are the people that we recruited over the last 1 year. Education program coordinator Chandra Devata, Dr. Michael knows him very well, and Nilam Chandra Chan and Rasmi Gurung and Parvina Kharti, all of these four staffs work for the literacy program in 42 schools implemented in the southern part of the Sorghum district. And Uzo Bumi, he's a science teacher trainer, and we also had to hire him because of the earlier trainer got health problems. And once we have them and we train them and coordinate them in the program activities and then the work about Himalayan Trust and the approach that we have adopted, and so we give onboarding training and orientation to them. And here I just want to highlight that in the REST project, when we built the school rebuilding project technicians, they were hired through people to people. And when we hire the hiring consultancy, then that means some 1 month of each of the staff salary has to be paid as a consultancy fee. And we did the hiring process by ourselves, and which means less financial burden to the trust, right? So we have to spend some time, we save the funds there. And more program officer, Dawa resigned, and so Professor Pradhan, former headmaster Shyam Krishna Pradhan's son, became our new program officer, and he's young, dynamic, and So here, upcoming new projects, I just want to highlight that the 70th anniversary is one of our new project activities that we are going to highlight next year. and for which will happen at Kumjuni and Kathmandu. And Peter, Sarah, and Kumbhakasana, and Romans, definitely local communities, Himalayan Trust Nepal and Himalayan Trust UK will be our partners and we'll be working jointly. And Karikura Secondary School, they are requesting for 4 classroom building construction, and for which we have got something like 3 million rupees from the German partners. But still, the school is looking for additional funding support from the local government as well as other donors. And that will be our project. And finally, clinic, the Forgotten Sherpas new trust, Forgotten Sherpas of Nepal Trust, based in Geraldine. George Hunter was their president, and he passed away last May at the age of 90. And he had a dream that he wants to build the Patale clinic. And so we committed, Himalayan Trust Nepal as a partner, we committed that we will build it. And so later we got funding support from our partner from Germany. We put $20,000 for this clinic, and Geraldine Forgotten Shepherds would raise an additional $5,000. So with that fund, we can build two clinic building with two clients. And then Zero TB in Himalayas, an initiative, a pilot initiative of tuberculosis screening and preventive therapy. So this is a new health project, health research project that we are going to work with Johns Hopkins University of USA. And Professor Kunjangpoji, he's a Tibetan, but now he's an American citizen. And he got, he's leading this project from USA, and Himalayan Trust Nepal is working as a co-partner. And for entire Kumbu schools and monasteries, we're going to screen the latent TB, if the kids have a latent TB or active TB. Yeah? So if they have tuberculosis, then once the tuberculosis is identified, then we'll provide the therapy, medical services to them. And so this is a research-based project, and we are doing partnering with the Johns Hopkins for the first time, and in future we will be getting more partnership with the Johns Hopkins University. And Kumjung School Assembly Hall is the Assembly Hall broke down in 2020 in the winter storm, and this hall isn't built yet, so we are looking for funding support for this.
What was the budget for it?
It's about 100 and I think about $200,000. And the previous design had about $200,000, but now we are trying to redesign, and if there's a possibility to reduce the cost, then we are looking for that, and our engineer DJ is working on that. And well, because primary school, actually it's a very small primary school, but they need a true classroom block, and we have partially secured funding. And primary school requires 3 classroom building. They have got 6 rooms for the classroom, but they need one computer lab, and one teacher's office, and then one library. So for which they need 3 small rooms building. So we are trying to look fund for this as well. So these are some of the construction and celebration projects targeted for the next year. And here I just want to, I'm sure Jason will provide all the financial report, and he might have better data here. And however, I just want to give a detail of the financial position or expenditure that we have performed over the last fiscal year. Teacher training and in-school support for literacy through integrated learning, LIL, and school-based teacher training program infrastructure, which includes repair and maintenance of classrooms and furniture, and the resource materials like teaching materials. The total budget we spent over the last fiscal year was $315,884. And teacher salary support, $101,779. And scholarship, $54,664. Likewise, Himalayan Trust share of Funde Hospital operation. Himalayan Trust New Zealand has been supporting for the operation and management of Hunde Hospital and community clinics since 2021. Has been 45,000 has been spent, and COVID prevention measures through. I used to communicate with Dr. Lin Sistran, and for the COVID prevention measures, we spent $2,413, and we still have some money left over and, in our account. And I think for which the urgent report has been sent to Jason, and if you have it. Administration and logistics, $126,775. That's the overall administration operation of Himalayan Trust Nepal. And the total expenditure over the last fiscal year was $646,000. And in the pie chart, it looks like this is the education program, the major component is the education program, and administration, and this is the Kundia support program. Some of the data didn't come. So our donors and partners, we don't get any funding support from Nepal government, but some of the projects like Monzu Water, they partner, they give some funding. But apart from that, we don't receive any funding from the government. But in terms of collaboration and coordination, we have to work closely with them. And Himalayan Trust New Zealand, of course, is the biggest supporter. And Himalayan New Zealand Aid is another donor. Himalayan Trust UK, they support like £5,000 per year for scholarships. They used to do more, but their interest has shifted to Tabrizung. But occasionally, after the earthquake, they supported quite a good money for the school rebuilding project. But apart from that, to keep the relationship between Himalayan Trust Nepal and UK, they support £5,000 every year for scholarship. And then the Forgotten Shepherds of Nepal Trust, Geraldine, they support for Padme and Guli Clinic. American Himalayan Foundation, they support for the Kundia Hospital and the Health Program Operation and Nancy Dental Clinic. And the Greater Himalayan Foundations, established in the memory of late Mingma Norbu Sherpa. So their support for scholarship. And Canada, they withdrew their funding for the hospitals and health from 2020. They still want to keep continuous connection with Himalayan Trust Nepal. And so sometimes obviously they put some donations. And likewise, EduTech Nepal is a crisis-based Marxism organization. Their support for the computer lab establishment in Sotumbo. And Hillary Foundation USA, I think Larry Hillary, now he's, I think he started his funding from 2015. So we still keep him in his organization as a partner, we acknowledge. And now the Foundation Swiss, this supports for the Pioneer School and scholarship program. And we are still working with them. Renwald National Mountain Foundation obviously funds for like the Monzu Water Project, but not a regular donor. Stuttgart, Germany is our regular donor and for supporting particularly for Kabul Hospital, but also Ingrid, the chairwoman, has supported $20,000 for the establishment of the Kunjung Soviet Visitor Center. And likewise, at Monzu, they supported for the community building. And Grand Circle Foundation is our great partner who supports for the school hostel project and water and high toilet and drinking water system in the schools. And Tami Shepherd Heritage Fund for the Tami Hostel. Werner Schemmers Foundation, Switzerland, France supports for the scholarship of the children whose father got killed in the Mount Everest or any mountain disasters. And Slovak Aid through our honorary consul, Pasundao Shepherd's Commission. Embassy also funded for the Monzu Water and Body Clinic. And likewise, Lights for Kids for Germany, they support for the supported for the solar projects. So these are our board members, and we have 9 members committee, and among them 2 are ladies, and we want to make a gender balance there, but it is taking longer time. And in terms of the program management, here we are. We have 8 people in Kathmandu base office. I'm working as a CEO, and then Nakupenzi as a program manager, Bobin as a finance manager, Robert Seton as a program officer, and Demaditi as an admin officer, and Porayanji as a finance officer, and Chiri and Mandar as a sub maintainer and a logistic supporter. And at the this is our education team. We have 10 people in the education team, and Mandar is in charge of the primary education. And for the medical side, under Kunde Hospital team, we have 9 people working under Kunde's management. Kunde Hospital itself has 7 staff, and 3 community has 3 clinics. Three clinics has 3 staff, but we recently handed over the Monzu clinic to the local government. So that's why we have only 9 in the Kumbu cluster of the health sector. And for partner and body, we have 4 staff, and he's our project manager, engineer, project coordinator, engineer, and he's the technical supervisor at the field for the construction and engineering section. I think I came to the end of the presentation, and thank you very much.